Hello guys, what's up? So this project I will show you, this was created I think last 2018. Yeah, 2018. So last 2018, company or the client I'm still working is Panalpina, so it's not DSB yet. So this is also a global transport and logistic company, and this year it's already merged, so it's already DSB. So before, we're not using CargoWise for the shipping logistic. Our global application for Panalpina, I mean, is using SAP, SAPTM. So you heard it right, SAPTM. So I have a task before, although we have a web application that we maintain. That web application is an ASP.NET MVC, and it is where it is the tool that the management or the operation in Asia Pacific use to manage booking, or for example, air export or ocean export, that's thing like that. So in this project, this is air export. So that is why I call it SAPTM air export pooling. So we connect to the web service in SAPTM, then we get the information. So the information is more about booking, because this is transport and logistic. We connect to the web service, and then we fold the booking information based on the criteria, of course. And then after we able to collect that information, we digest it, every certain information or particular data that our web application in Asia Pacific needed. So basically, we have going to connect to the web service, download the information, and save it to our database in the Asia Pacific. And then from the database or from the web application, the operation or the user can manage the booking. All right, so this is the application. I name it SAPTM Air Export Pooling. So this is console application. So in our app config file, you can see here, this is the endpoint. So I think this is WCF, but that's the SAPTM. I just call it. I'm not the one who built their services, so they just give us the, but I think this is already decommissioned, because I think Panalpina is not, or DSB is not using the SAPTM anymore. And then this is our connection. This is the database that the web application, and some criteria that we are going to use. For example, this one, that the value would be our house code, which is 72659. And if we add, there's a lot of bus code. And the file type is our export one, like that, something like that. So there are criteria. And so this is because we are saving, we are going to connect to the database. So, and since the database is already existing, so I just use the entity framework 6.0 database first approach. So I created this ADMX model. So I just selected a table that I'm going to use. So basically the most important table is this one, TEE house. So because we don't have the database now, so I cannot test it. So basically, as you can see, there are lots of field names in the table. That's all about booking information. So this is transport and logistics, so you know that information. All right, so since this is database first approach, so it will create its own property like that, the T is the lots of property, the else like that. So you are not going to create your own model, but it will generated by the LLMs or the engine. And then I create this interface. So basically generic interface, iCrud. Basically it's just a CRUD operation. So there's a create, it will add or insert to the database, generic. So what model we are going to pass, yeah, the properties or the model. For example, the house, like that, the history, like that. Delete, update, and there's a read, it will read. Basically, I think this is not being used. And then you have another class that I have created. This is the STD file. So this is all just definition or the information in our web service in SAPTM. For example, they have this STD partner. So this is the definition or the properties. Yeah, with the partner account number like that. STD file text ID. So I know there are lots of properties, but I only created what do I need. So if I need this particular property, so I created it. This one, there are lots of properties, but I only created the most important that will be using in my program. All right. And then I have ECPWS. So basically this is made of the web service. So you can see configuration. This is how we call the web service itself. So let's see if it's upsetting. Let's see if the criteria is here. And then we add this to the dictionary. Something like that. And then the find is if a method. This is finding a single. So number of rows we define here in the upsetting. So the maximum of the rows to be retrieved is 200 rows per retrieval. So by the way, after we deploy this program in the Windows scheduler or scheduler. So it will run every 5 minutes. It will fall data every 5 minutes. And every falling should have 200 records. But of course, it will be filtered based on the criteria. So these are the criteria, for example, file type, and then 30 this. I think this is 30. Add this, minus this. This issue, it depends on the issue that from. So then this is, if you are going to pull complete file, then the security like that. Right. Then you are going to post the CP file. Alright, so this is the main program. So basically, this is a console application. So I have a logger here. I'm just using inlog. So you can find the website inlog. That's a good logger also. So after you define it, of course, you have to install the inlog. So there's an inlog here. So you can get the nugget file, install inlog. Okay, so that's why logger info, start finding new files, and then also find SAP files, the method in our web service class, right? And then this is the most important one. So I just commented here. So the asynchronous way is to make our polling asynchronously, right? So meaning to say, it's asynchronous. It can poll. It can have mini trades. So that's a system that trading. So just basically like that. Task that does run. This is the, we have the run method here. I mean the read method, passing the item. Here, so passing the WS item, the office is so if you hardcode, you find the file ID this one, but if this is just for testing if you are good. But if you are not going to hard code it, just in real production, you have to do that. Field 0 item, file ID. So that is individual ID that you are going to fold. Right, so then there are some condition. For example, the create offset ID should be called SAPTM, and traffic directory is one. I think that is traffic directory is one. I forgot what's the traffic directory. And then this is now my house. I mean the class my house. So created a class house here for the saving. So house, I inherit the scp file. So that's it. This is now the data that you're going to put in our table. So basically, for example, house number. So get from here, booking number, there is we can't record the time, so there is a inline function here, have to get the booking number, so just like that, to return the booking number. Alright, so there is just transactions, just there is entities that we have. So we are checking the database if existing or not, and we'll get a return a new booking number. Okay. So there are lots of condition here based on the requirements, right? For example, this one. This should be. This is a assignment. This is the last UID, so just like it also okay, last update, file ID, house file ID, status, hit segment status, when you click the segment status, so there is it. House that to offer cost wise, status is voided, else, and then that's sorry. Status is 01, that's held by series, so that's basically status that will be displayed in our application. So a lot of things here is just like getting the data, format it, that is required in our application. Yeah. That's after you are able to get everything, then you have to save it in our database. For example, this one, service label, house of a service label, and then there is a empty ship information as delivery terms, commodity, special cargo pool like that, this lab, expected gross weight like that. So there are some other of the formula. So basically I'm not familiar with the terms in the cargo and logistics, so everything I did here I also asked to the that time it, we have system analyst and Altina side, so they are the one who lay out the requirements, and also in the SAP sub-team side you can ask, for example, if you want to get the gross weight, what is the definition in the SAP side, so you can ask them. Or you can go to the web service definition. They have also the documentation. So if we need gross weight, so it's TOTCEW in there. On their side. And then like that. Okay, so there are lots, for example, selling with currency. So there are lots of condition. Selling with type, that condition, loading instructions, like that. Okay, after you already get all the information, so this is now our TA helper. So this is how we are going to save data to the database. So TA helper basically This is the implementation of our inherit iCrude interface passing the TAHouse model house, that is the table name, property of the table. So basically in add, so this is our entity. It's connecting to the database, and then we're using transaction here. And then the model here, just add ships in this. If now things wrong, commit, it will be saved in the database. If there are error, we'll roll back the transaction and through the exception. I'll also use the read. Basically, reading just to this and update like that. So, basically, the most important table that we're going to save when updater is the TA house. Yeah, you can see that's the updating. And this is like so from here. That's the condition. So you know, guys, that this program, when deployed, it will have create or save a single, 200 shipping information in 1 minute. It is. I think that's the goal, but it's not. It cannot be. I was able to get top information, 50 walking information in 1 minute. So basically, this is just for reference. So this program has been terminated after penalty nice merge in DSB. So this is also ascending. What happened? So just use SMTP client. So that's it for this program. So it's just really simple, but it's a business. So I mean, that's the bulk information the business needs every day. Okay, so this is the most important, guys. Task list. It will allow to read the method. This one read will get the information and based on the criteria. But it will run sync asynchronously, so that makes faster. Whereas if you are going to synchronize that, I think one file, one booking file, it will take you almost 1 minute. But when you do it asynchronously, in 1 minute, I think you can have read 50 files. So that's important, because in this application, it's very important that before the booking is done or being finished, it's already reached to our web application in Asia Pacific. So what the requirements is to get the 200 booking information in 1 minute. That's not possible. So maybe we can have, so what we did before, I think we created 10 schedule for this, just to meet their requirement that to have 200 booking in 1 minute. So if this one single program can have 150 bookings in 1 minute, so we created, I think that was 5 scheduler in different server. So that's it. So it's just basically reading the web service from the SAPTM side, pulling the data, and then saving to the database. So you can see that you have helper, for example, TA house helper. So basically, that's the saving, adding, and updating the database after you're getting the information. So it's the model. So where do you need the model? for the setting of the model is in here. This is where you set the model property or the value. This one. So, yeah, this is the field name and then the value like that. Okay. Then it, I just put a plug as one, meaning we are going to insert it. Helper that create that is the module name. And then of course you update the comment. Then if the plug is not one, so its meaning is update. The updated service. So it's really that's it. The other one that is. So if you have question guys, clarification, or you want to comment out, you want more tasks, if you happen to have like this project that you are going to get from the web service, from the web service, yeah, you just comment below. And yeah, of course this is one of the projects that I created before. So there are many projects that I created, so I'm just blogging there, so also I can also take a look from time to time. Maybe I can get some information on how I did it before. Yeah. If you have future project and there is a functionality that almost the same with what you created before, so it can make your development faster, right? Of course, the technology is always changing, but as a reference, it's going to really help you. Alright guys, thank you for listening, and if you like this and you want more video like this, hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you, bye.